The flu isn't just a seasonal nuisance. It's a serious illness that's spreading rapidly across the world right now. Understanding its symptoms, causes, and prevention is more important than ever. So, how can you protect yourself and your loved ones? Stay with us as we break down everything you need to know about the flu. In this video, we'll cover everything you need to know about the flu, including what the flu is and when flu season occurs, common symptoms and causes of the flu, how the flu spreads and when to see a doctor, diagnosis and treatment options, whether you should stay home when you're sick, ways to prevent the flu and potential complications. What is the flu? Influenza, the flu, is a very contagious viral infection. It's a respiratory illness that can affect your nose, throat, and sometimes your lungs. There are two main types of influenza viruses: influenza type A, influenza type B. Most people who have the flu are infected with the influenza type A virus. There are also many subtypes and strains. The virus that causes COVID-19 is different from the virus that causes influenza. Influenza infections are more serious than the common cold. They can cause major outbreaks and severe disease. When is flu season? In the United States, flu season typically runs from October through May, with the peak hitting between December and February. Flu viruses love cold, dry conditions, which is why they're more active during these months. For example, the 2020 to 2021 flu season was unusually mild thanks to all the COVID-19 precautions, whereas the 2023 to 2024 season was moderately severe, much like what we saw before the pandemic. When should you get your flu shot? The ideal time to get your flu shot is in September or October, right before the season starts. Remember, it takes about 2 weeks for the vaccine to kick in and become fully effective. Here's a quick guide on when to get vaccinated. Most people aim to get your shot by the end of October. Pregnant women, it's best to get vaccinated during your first or second trimester. Children, get their first dose as soon as the vaccine is available. People with certain conditions, if you're about to start treatments like chemotherapy, consider getting vaccinated earlier. Why get vaccinated early? Getting vaccinated early means you're protected by the time flu activity starts to spike in late fall and winter. Plus, if you're pregnant, getting vaccinated not only protects you, but also passes on protection to your baby through the placenta. What are the symptoms of the flu? The symptoms of flu may include fever and chills,
cough,
sore throat, sneezing and stuffy or runny nose, tiredness,
headache,
muscle aches and joint pains. Sometimes you may also have abdominal, tummy pain, nausea, vomiting. These symptoms are more common in children with the flu. It's possible to get the flu even if you have been vaccinated. This may be due to your illness being caused by a flu strain not covered by this year's vaccine. What causes the flu? There are four types of influenza virus: influenza A virus, influenza B virus, influenza C virus, influenza D virus. Influenza types A and B are usually the cause of seasonal flu. Influenza C virus infections generally cause mild illness and are not thought to cause human epidemics. Influenza D viruses mainly affect cows. They are not known to cause illness in people. Some strains of the influenza virus can also infect other animals. Animal influenza viruses are distinct from human seasonal influenza viruses and do not easily pass between people. How is influenza spread? Influenza is spread through droplets from your nose or throat. This can be from coughing and sneezing. These droplets can be breathed in by someone else who may then get the flu. The droplets can also land on surfaces. Anyone who touches these surfaces and then touches their nose or mouth can also catch the flu. When should I see my doctor? See your doctor if you are concerned about your symptoms. Have a high fever, over 38 degrees Celsius. Have a cough that's not improving. Are in a high-risk group, see below. Wear a mask when attending your medical appointment to help lower the spread of viruses to other people. If you have mild flu-like symptoms and are otherwise fit and healthy, there is usually no need to see a doctor. Am I in a high-risk group for influenza? You are more likely to get very sick from influenza and need hospital care if you are younger than 5 years old, aged 65 years or older, an Aboriginal and or Torres Strait Islander person, pregnant. You may also be at risk of a severe influenza infection if you have heart disease, a chronic lung condition such as asthma, kidney disease, diabetes. You are also at risk of severe illness if you are immunocompromised, have a weakened immune system, are homeless, live in an aged care facility. How is the flu diagnosed? Your doctor will ask about your symptoms and examine you, including listening to your chest using a stethoscope. To confirm a diagnosis of influenza, your doctor will arrange a flu test. This involves taking a sample of cells and mucus from your nose or throat using a sterile cotton swab. This sample is then sent to a pathology laboratory for testing using a polymerase chain reaction, PCR, test. A PCR test can find the genetic material of the virus or bacteria causing your symptoms. Your doctor may also test you for COVID-19. Can I diagnose influenza at home? You can diagnose flu at home using an over-the-counter rapid antigen self-test, RAT. These are like the ones used to test for COVID-19. Some RATs can test for multiple viruses like influenza A, influenza B, COVID-19, respiratory syncytial virus, RSV. How is the flu treated? Most people will get better by themselves within 7 to 10 days, and without any treatment. Some things you can do to ease your flu symptoms are getting plenty of rest, drinking plenty of fluids to prevent dehydration, keeping warm. You can also take paracetamol, ibuprofen, or other over-the-counter medicines to treat any pain or fever. Always follow the instructions on the packet. Various gargles, throat sprays, and lozenges are available for the relief of a sore throat. Some people find warm fluids, such as warm water with honey or sucking ice, helpful. Antiviral treatments. Your doctor may suggest antiviral medicines if you're at risk of severe illness. Antiviral medicines help to shorten the length of your illness and reduce your risk of complications. Antiviral treatments are most effective when given within 48 hours of you getting symptoms. Antiviral treatments are not usually given to healthy people aged 5 to 65 years. They are most effective for people with a high risk of complications, such as older people and people with other health conditions. Antibiotics. Antibiotics are not generally used to treat flu. This is because antibiotics do not work for viral infections. If your doctor gives you antibiotics, they may treat complications of influenza. Taking antibiotics when you don't need them can increase the risk of antibiotic resistance in the future. Should I stay at home? If you are sick with the flu, stay home and avoid close contact with other people until you feel better. If your child has the flu, keep them at home until they are symptom-free. Can the flu be prevented? The best way to prevent the flu is to have a flu vaccination every year. Flu vaccine. Influenza vaccines prevent different types of influenza A and influenza B. There are different types of influenza vaccines. Speak with your doctor about the best vaccine for you. You should get your annual influenza vaccine anytime from April onwards. This will protect you for the peak flu season. You get the highest level of protection in the first 3 to 4 months after vaccination. You can get the flu vaccine at the same time as you get most other vaccines. When should I get the influenza vaccine? You should have the flu shot every year. Most people only need one injection. Some people need two shots for weeks apart. These are children aged 6 months to 9 years old getting the flu shot for the first time. People getting the flu shot for the first time after a stem cell transplant, organ transplant, or treatment called CAR T-cell therapy. Other ways to prevent influenza. Good hygiene is one of the best ways to help prevent flu and other illnesses from spreading. Try to wash your hands regularly. Cover your mouth and nose when coughing or sneezing. Throw used tissues in the bin straight away. Don't share cups, plates, cutlery, and towels with other people. Influenza is an airborne disease. The virus is spread when people talk, cough, and sneeze. Wearing a face mask can help lower your chance of catching the flu. If you are sick, you can avoid touching your eyes, nose, and mouth. Stay at home. Influenza infections can lead to serious complications such as pneumonia, breathing problems,
death.
These complications are most likely in people at higher risk of severe illness. As we wrap up, remember that taking care of yourself and those around you is the best way to weather any season. With a little preparation and a lot of care, we can protect our communities and make a real difference. Stay safe, stay informed, and keep looking out for one another. Thank you for joining us. Here's to a healthier tomorrow for everyone.